afternoon to our chief guest, Honorable Director of Higher Education, Shri Bhushan K. Savaikar, Deputy Director of Higher Education, Professor Dr. F.M. Nadaf, President Goa Vidya Prasaram Mandal's General Body, Shri Bhaskar Khandeparkar, Chairman of Goa Vidya Prasarak Mandal's Working Committee, Shri Krishna Shetye, Principal of Goa Vidya Prasarak Mandal's Dr. Dada Vidya College of Education, Dr. Jojan Matthew, and everyone present here. On behalf of Goa Vidya Prasarak Mandal's Dr. Dada Vidya College of Education, I warmly welcome you to Dr. Dada Vidya Memorial Lecture and felicitation of the meritorious students for the batch 2023-24. On this auspicious day, I invite the BEd students to welcome you all with a beautiful dance.
Yeah.
Goa Vidya Prasarak Mandal was founded by eminent personalities and visionaries like Dr. Ramchandra Pandurang Vaidya, popularly known as Dr. Dada Vaidya, Shri Sitaram Kerkar and Shri Vinayak Sir Jyotishi on the 2nd of October 1911 with a vision to impart education that was rooted in the cultural heritage of the nation with a view to build Goans and make them responsible citizens of the nation. Goa Vidya Prasarak Mandal is an institution that was so wonderfully created and crafted by its founders, as it skillfully depicts Dr. Dada Vaidya's ideas, thoughts and commitments towards education, while also empowering individuals to gain knowledge and become patriotic individuals of the country. Dr. Dada Vaidya's views and concepts of education are relevant even today. We understand the gravity of his vision, especially now, since the social and governance considerations are being included in the NEP 2020. Therefore, to commemorate the birth anniversary of such a great visionary, the Goa Vidya Prasarak Mandal has initiated a lecture series since 2021 titled Dr. Dada Vaidya Memorial Lecture. Today marks the fourth lecture of the series titled Are Humans Responsible for Triggering Climate Disasters? On this note, we will now commence with the lighting of the lamp, followed by the floral tribute to the portrait of Dr. Dada Vaidya. To do the honors, we have an eminent and distinguished gathering among us. May I request the dignitaries to join us in the ceremony. I humbly invite the chief guest, Honorable Director of Higher Education, Shri Bhushan K. Savekar, guest of honor and keynote speaker, Deputy Director of Higher Education, Professor Dr. F.M. Nadaf, President of Goa Vidya Prasarak Mandal's General Body, Shri Bhaskar Khandeparkar, Chairman of Goa Vidya Prasarak Mandal's Working Committee, Shri Krishna Shetye, Principal of GVM's Dr. Dada Vaidya College of Education, Dr. George and Matthew, and all the others to kindly do the honors. Thank you. Thank you. I request our principal, Dr. Jojen Matthew. Escort our dignitaries to the dais. as the principal of Goa Vidya Prasarak Mandal's Dr. Dada Vaidya College of Education, Dr. Georgian Matthew is extremely resourceful and efficient, and I request Dr. Georgian Matthew to welcome the gathering.
Good afternoon. It's our privilege to join in the celebration of the birth anniversary of our founder, Dr. Dada Vaidya. Dr. Dada Vaidya was a multi-faceted personality who contributed significantly to medicine, education, arts, literature, politics, and to social upliftment. Realizing the importance of education for social upliftment, our founder, Dr. Dada Vaidya, along with Sri Sidharam Kerkar and Sri Vinayak Sarjodshi, founded Goa Vidya Prasarak Mandal and its first institute, AJD Almeida High School, in 1911. Of the various agencies imparting education, like school, family, religion, etc., the school is the most important, and it plays a major role in the physical, emotional, intellectual, and moral development of the child. Out of all the variables that explain the achievement of students, teacher effectiveness is one of the most important factors that contribute to the achievement of students. Realizing this, the visionaries of Goa Vidya Prasarak Mandal established a college of education in Ponda in the year 1993. GVM's Dr. Dada Vaidya College of Education is a unique institution in the state of Goa. We have courses ranging from pre-primary to PhD in education. This is the only institution in the state of Goa offering a master's in education and a PhD in the faculty of education. The college has been doing well consistently in all the areas of its development. This year, we have been accredited by NAC with a B++ grade. In the first cycle, we got a B grade, and the second cycle, we got a B+ grade, and this is the third cycle, we got a B++ grade. Last year, three of our faculty members were awarded PhD in education. Now we have five faculty members with PhD degrees in the faculty of education. One of our faculty members is on study leave for completing his PhD, and others are pursuing their part-time PhD, and I am sure that within 1 or 2 years, all of our staff members will complete their doctoral degree in education. We have signed MOUs with various state, national, and international level organizations. Last year, we conducted an international conference in association with AERIO, Association of International Researchers of Indian Origin, with whom we have an MOU. Our MA department conducted a national conference this year on higher education and ethics, and 100 scholars, they participated and presented papers. We have various courses, as I said, pre-primary, B.Ed. and M.Ed. We had 100% result for our pre-primary program last year. 30 students, they passed M.Ed. degree with 4 distinctions, 25 first classes and 1 second class. For B.Ed., out of 106 students appeared for the exam, 71 students passed with distinction, 28 with first class and 1 with a second class. I congratulate all the students who passed out from our institution last year, especially the meritorious students who are present today to receive their certificates and scholarships. We are privileged to have Honorable Director of Higher Education, Sri Bhushan Savinkar, as our chief guest as we celebrate the birth anniversary of our founder, Dr. Dada Vaidya, and felicitate our meritorious students of last year batch. When I met sir to invite him for this program, he was very happy to know that we are celebrating Dr. Dada Vaidya's birth anniversary every year. And he told me he would share a few things about our founder today. On behalf of Goa Vidya Prasarak Mandal and GVM's Dr. Dada Vaidya College of Education, I welcome you, sir, to this program. We have Professor F.M. Nadaf as guest of honor today. Sir will be delivering Dr. Dada Vaidya Memorial Lecture on the topic, Are Humans Responsible for Triggering Climate Disasters? Sir was one of our guests for this celebration last year also. So we were looking for a person who could speak on this current topic. As you all know that recently we had very big landslides in Kerala, Wayanad and other places also. So we thought it would be better to take a topic, a current topic, and we will have this lecture on that current topic today. I am very happy that Dr. Nadaf is with us. He will be speaking to us on this very important topic. We are privileged to have our President of the General Body, Goa Vidya Prasarak Mandal, Sri Bhaskar Kandeparkar, sir. It was sir's initiative that this institute was established in 1993. It was sir's initiative that we started celebrating the birth anniversary of Dr. Dada Vaidya. Sir has told us that this is to be done every year and we need to invite all the heads of the institution. And we have been doing this since 4 years. So this is the fourth one. So sir's guidance and support helped us to grow to the present level. It's not only that for this institution, but for many other institutions of Goa Vidya Prasarak Mandal. We are honored to have our chairman, working committee, Sri Krishna Shettye. Sir worked in various capacities with Goa Vidya Prasarak Mandal. Sir has contributed immensely for the infrastructure development of many institutions, including our college. And sir is available 24/7 for any support and guidance, and we are very thankful to the management for all the support that they give us. So we welcome you, sir, to this program. I welcome all the other honorable members of the working committee who are present today with us. We have Secretary Sri Jayan Mandurkar, sir, Vice Chairman Sri Ashok Nagvekar, sir, Treasurer Sri Prabhat Shikarkar, member, and other members. I welcome you all to this program. I also welcome the heads of GVM's institutions. I welcome the members of IQAC, members of the local management committee, staff and members of other GVM's institutions, staff and students of GVM's Dr. Dada Vaidya College of Education. Once again, I welcome one and all to this program. Thank you, Devarek.
Thank you, sir. Present among us for this function is a dynamic personality and a remarkable visionary in the field of education. Chairman of GVM's Working Committee, Sri Krishna Shettye. Sri Krishna Shettye completed his schooling from AJD Almeida High School, Ponda, and his graduation from Srimati Parvatibai Chogle College of Arts and Science, Markham. He joined Hindustan Sevak IT of India, where he rendered his services for 16 years while simultaneously launching a private business in civil construction and real estate. He is currently managing his own private company called Shettye Homes and Real Estate Private Limited as the managing director. Being a passionate, avid, and voracious reader, He has in his possession a huge collection of books. He consistently captivates the hearts and minds of the audience through his eloquent oratory skills. I now request Shri Krishna Shetye to kindly address the gathering.
Chief guest of today's function, Shri Bhushan Savarkar, Director of Higher Education. Guest of honor, Professor Nadaf, and today's keynote speaker, President Bhaskar Khandeparkar, President of General Body, Principal Jojan Manji, my colleagues in Working Committee, Secretary Jayant Mandurkar, Vice Chairman Ashok Madwekar, Treasurer Prabhat Chikirkar, and General Body Member Mr. Vagai. I'm audible? Am I audible? My dear students, teachers, principals, heads of the institutions, and friends, today it gives me immense pleasure today here on the occasion of the birth anniversary lecture series. The birth anniversary was celebrated on 8th of this month, but due to Chaturthi, we have to organize this function little late, and it is today. I'm very happy and delighted because this lecture series and this function is being organized on every birth anniversary of Dr. Dada Vaidya, who being the founder member of this institution. In 1911, this institute was founded when there was only one school. Today we are 22. Today we are 22 institutions under the umbrella of Goa Vidya Prasarak Mandal, with a student strength of about 10,500 and teacher strength or staff strength of about 670 staff members. With all this, if you see the exponential growth of this institution, it is only the legacy which is left by the founding fathers, their principles, their thoughts, because of which, on which we are marching and we are walking, therefore we could take this institute to this level. Now, I congratulate the Goa Vidya Prasarak Mandal's Dada Vaidya College of Education for their organizing this birth anniversary of Dada Vaidya, as well as felicitating the students who have excelled in the examination of the B.Ed. course, who will be felicitated. I congratulate them also. Having said this, without taking much of your time, because keynote address will be of half an hour and the rest of the speakers will also have to speak, and therefore I thank you all for listening me for very few words of mine. Thank you all.
Thank you, sir. It is my privilege to introduce an esteemed personality today present among us, the President of Goa Vidya Prasarak Mandal's General Body, Shri Bhaskar Khandeparkar. Sir completed his schooling from AJD Almeida High School, Ponda, and is an architect by profession with an experience of more than 30 years in this field. Prior to this, he has also worked as a lecturer in the College of Architecture. He pursued his master's in history at the ripe age of 60, which proves that age is just a number. He is known for his zeal in the field of education and his passionate contribution towards the development of Goa Vidya Prasarak Mandal, especially GVM's Dr. Dada Vaidya College of Education. Known for his visionary outlook and creative approach, He continuously inspires those around him to strive for excellence and innovation. I request, sir, to kindly address the gathering.
Chief guest of today's function, Shri Bhushan Savekar, Director of Higher Education, guest of Honorable Professor Nadda, other dignitaries of the dais, invitees, professors, and my dear friends. Well, I am here to pay my tributes to the founder of Goa Vidya Prasarak Mandal, Dr. Dada Vaidya, whose birth anniversary was on 8th of September. He was born on 8th September in 1859 and passed away in 1947. We commemorate his anniversary. We also celebrate 2nd of October, the foundation day of Goa Vidya Prasarak Mandal. And also, we also make a mention the contribution of Dr. Dada Vaidya in founding Goa Vidya Prasarak Mandal. But I must tell you, he is not a founder of Goa Vidya Prasarak Mandal alone, but he was a founder of entire new education in the state of Goa. In 1910, when Portugal became republic, in the sense Portugal became democracy, they allowed the civil society to form their own educational institutes. And it was Dr. Dada Vaidya who brought a team of teachers from Pune, where most of them were graduates from Ferguson College. 2 to 3 professors were Apte, Fatak and Musker were teachers in our school, and 2 teachers were sent to Panji, 2 were sent to Maksa. So, and other institutes that were started along with Goa Vidya Prasarak Mandal, that was Mustifan Sanstha in Panji, Jnan Prasarak Sanstha in Maksa, and later on Damodar Vidyalaya in Margao. These were the founding institutes of education in Goa. Otherwise, prior to that, education was entirely managed by the government, and that too the teaching was in Portuguese language. Very little of English. There were only 1 or 2 English schools in Goa at that time. So we must recognize the contribution of Dr. Dada Vaidya, not only as regards to GVM, as he was a resident of this place, but he also managed to start these institutes in these places, because unless there were good set of teachers who could teach in English and Marathi, no other person would have been in a position to start any institute. So we must recognize the role of teachers in founding Goa Vidya Prasarak Mandal, Jnan Prasarak, Mustifan and Damodar Vidyalaya in Margao. So his anniversary cannot be restricted to Ponda alone. But also government must recognize the fact that Dr. Dada Vaidya was a moving personality who played a great role in establishment of formal education in the state of Goa, with founding of these institutes along the very same period of 1910 to 1912. Now this contribution, because unless the contacts of Dada Vaidya had not used his contacts in the state, like in Maharashtra state or particularly in Pune, there was no possibility of 8 to 10 teachers who were graduates from Ferguson College to come to Goa and start teaching. The entire responsibility of those batch of teachers was taken by Dada Vaidya, and of course later on shifted to the people from Maksa, Peni and Margao. So we must recognize this contribution. Other is those periodicals or publications which Dr. Dada Vaidya started. See, whenever we learn history, even when we teach history, it is about history of about Raja Maharajas, you know, the king, queens, dynasty. We never learn the history of the society. We don't know how the society lived there. What was the poverty level? What was the educational level? How people lived? what were the diseases that afflicted them, how they survived, how they died, how they led a happy life or healthy life. These things are never taught in history. What is taught is the Maharaja and the Nizams and the Bajiravs and what they did, how many times they married. All these things are taught to the students. But the economic history, which is very, very important, how people lived since the past, that is never taught to the students. But if you read these books, if you read these publications which were published 100 years back, you get to know how about the society of Goa and little of Maharashtra. What were the problems that afflicted the society? What Dr. Dadavaitya did to remove those problems? All these things are available in these publications. Even there was an epidemic like COVID in 1920, wherein a lot of people died, schools had to be closed. Similar thing happened after 100 years. So if you refer to these publications, you get to know the history of the society, what kind of people lived. Now it's almost 100 years have passed. Till now, the education was handled by the government and civil society. But now there are commercial interests. The commercial establishments, the education is commercialized, and many top brands have come to Goa and are going to come. So I wouldn't specify what we are going to do, but it is going to be very difficult for the societies like us. We have to plan out how we are going to confront commercialization of education, and that is going to be important work for the government also to guide us on how to go ahead with how to fight these new brands which are connected with education very, very recently with the establishment of schools and colleges in the state of Goa. So I can't specify what we will plan to do, because I may not be there to witness all that. But we have to take that point of view that how GVM is going to confront all this in 10 to 15 years hence. Well, I again pay my tributes on my personal behalf, on behalf of Goa Vidya Prasarak School family, to Dr. Dadavaitya, the founder, because of whom we all are here today in the spread of education in Goa and being far and wide. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. We now begin with a felicitation program. I congratulate all the felicitees and their family members. As we strive to uphold the values, ethics, and excellence of GVM's Dr. Dadavaitya College of Education, we have with us our proud students who continue to uphold the name of our institution and serve as brand ambassadors through academic excellence in the Goa University examinations and carry this legacy wherever they go. It is our honor to felicitate their hard work, dedication, and marvelous achievement in the institution. We have the chief guest, Honorable Director of Higher Education, Shri Bhushan K. Savekar, to do the honors and felicitate our students. Before the chief guest felicitates the meritorious students, I request Dr. Honey Babu to introduce the chief guest.
Thank you, ma'am. It's my pleasure to introduce the chief guest for this function, Sri Bhushan K. Savekar, Director of Higher Education, Government of Goa. Sir is well qualified and resourceful. He holds his bachelor's degree in commerce and master's in law from Goa University. While shouldering the responsibilities as junior administrative grade officer of Goa Civil Service, he was appointed as Director of Higher Education. Earlier to that, he has also worked in various departments of Goa government like Education, Revenue, Election and Information Commission. He was also the officer on special duty for coordinating the G20 meetings held in Goa and the chairman of State